They just came out with brand new vegan sleep vitamins.
So I have been trying these out.
I take an additional 2,000 milligrams of vitamin C. Vitamin C is incredible.
A lot of you guys will probably have something that looks somewhat similar to this. That's a lot of bottles.
Some experts claim that taking vitamins can be lifesavers, whereas others argue that it's just a waste of time or even dangerous.
And some scary articles have been coming out showing taking high doses of certain vitamins increases risks of cancer.
Vitamin supplements have become a crucial part of our society. In the US alone, over 52% of all adults take some form of supplements. The vitamin supplement market has become a multi-billion industry. Today, the global supplement market size is valued at roughly $152 billion. Vitamin supplements are often good, but in some cases, they also can become dangerous. My name is Clemens, and today we'll see how vitamin supplements can help us or damage our bodies. Our story today begins in the middle of the 18th century. A scientist named James Lind studied a weird phenomenon which often occurred at sea. Sailors, who largely seemed healthy, suddenly reported to feel weak and tired. Over time, affected individuals started bleeding from gum and skin and had less and less red blood cells. They experienced a disease which becomes fatal in its final stage, scurvy. Back then, people had different theories why scurvy broke out. Some thought that scurvy was caused by the sea, a lack of exercise, or morale. So just do a couple of push-ups and sing some pirate songs and everything will be fine. Well, that didn't work. James Lind has heard of an alternative theory which stated that the absence of fresh vegetables and fruits leads to scurvy. So he decided to give some scurvy patients oranges and lemons and found that they recovered. There was something inside lemons which cured scurvy. In 1870, scientists tried to tackle an issue during the siege of Paris. You see, the city was cut off from milk supplies from the countryside and many children died. It has been known that milk was important for the health of children. So scientists tried to replicate milk, but they just couldn't find a sufficient formula. Also here, there was something unknown in milk which helped the survival of children. And in the 20th century, scientists found out what it was. Vitamins. Vitamins are molecules which are needed in small amounts for the body to work. In humans, there are 13 vitamins, and the common names are easy to remember: vitamin A, B1 to 8, C, D, E, and vitamin K. K doesn't really fit. Vitamin K is named after the Danish word for coagulation. Just some fun fact in case you want to bracket your next party or get ghosted by whoever you're talking to. Vitamins cannot be made by the human body in sufficient amounts, and so they have to be taken up. We normally get vitamins for our diet from bacteria in our guts or are made by ourselves when being exposed to sunlight. Once vitamins enter our bodies, they have different important roles. Let me rhyme this for you. Okay. Vitamin A controls the growth of a cell and helps your eyesight not to go to hell. Vitamin D acts like a hormone and regulates the metabolism of your bone. Vitamin C and E act as antioxidants and deactivate harmful substances under any circumstance. After vitamins have been discovered, scientists started to make them artificially in the laboratory. In the 1950s, mass production and marketing of vitamins started. People all over the world began taking vitamin supplements. The common belief is that vitamins are always good, but this is not the case, as we will see. Vitamins have important roles in our bodies, but the issue is that vitamin supplements are not regulated. Everyone can get infinite amounts of vitamin supplements without proper knowledge about possible risks. And this can lead to a phenomenon called vitamin toxicity. Vitamin toxicity means that someone has taken so many vitamins that they have side effects. BC is a man who always tried to maintain a healthy lifestyle. He regularly worked out and never suffered any major disease. One day, however, he woke up with a strong headache. He thought it would just be the weather, nothing to worry about. But his headache didn't go away. It continued and continued. After a couple of days, he started vomiting and quickly lost weight. He decided to go to the hospital, where doctors conducted first tests. A biopsy showed that his kidneys were profoundly damaged. And this was weird, since BC was healthy, he never did any drugs and never drank alcohol. He only admitted taking vitamin C supplements on a daily basis. BC read online articles about vitamin C and how it helps to burn fat after workouts. Additionally, he has heard that vitamin C helps to prevent a common cold, and since flu season was coming, he doubled his daily dosage of vitamin C supplements. What BC didn't know was that vitamin C can also become toxic if taken in high amounts. When the body receives too much vitamin C, it normally converts it into oxalate, which exits the body via urine. However, above a certain threshold, this process doesn't work properly anymore, and oxalate binds to minerals and forms crystals. These crystals can occur in the kidneys, where they can lead to the formation of kidney stones. This explains the damages to BC's kidneys. At the same time, BC was undergoing a strict meat-based diet. The doctors soon realized that this could lead to a second issue. You see, meat contains iron and vitamin C supports the intake of iron. This means that a meat-based diet combined with vitamin C supplements can lead to an accumulation of iron in the body. The additional iron can then lead to serious damages to the heart, liver, pancreas, thyroid, or the central nervous system. Fortunately, BC has only recently changed his diet and there were no detectable damages in his other organs. The doctors prohibited BC from taking vitamin supplements and kept him in the hospital until his symptoms improved. He was discharged a while later and could live a normal life. You might not think that vitamin supplements are only dangerous for fitness fanatics. That's wrong. Take the case of CM, a 4-year-old boy who was presented to the emergency room after suffering from fatigue, extreme thirstiness, and irritability. The doctors also noted that he appeared pale and had inflamed lips. So they took a blood sample and found high levels of calcium in his blood. The question was, where does this calcium come from? So the doctors dug a bit deeper and they found also high levels of vitamin A in his blood. As it turns out, the boy's family has recently switched to a plant-based diet and everyone received vitamin supplements. And while all the other members of the family were fine, the young boy developed symptoms. But also fortunately here, the doctors realized quite fast what was going on. The boy received standard treatments and was discharged from the hospital after 2 weeks. And 1 month after the incidents, the calcium levels in his blood were back to normal. In the first 2 cases, vitamin toxicity was recognized early and the patients could be cured. Unfortunately, not all patients are so lucky. Kashmir is a region where many people suffer from vitamin D deficiency, and so doctors often prescribe high levels of vitamin D. But if the dosages are not well controlled, vitamin D supplements can also lead to vitamin toxicity. In one study, 10 patients were documented who suffered from vitamin D toxicity. All 10 adults took vitamin D supplements and showed high levels of calcium in their blood. 8 of the 10 patients exhibited extensive damages in their kidneys, and adult doctors did everything they could. Only 8 patients recovered. Of course, vitamin supplements are not always bad for us. Vitamins are important, and vitamin supplements can help to prevent vitamin deficiencies. The thing is that we mostly get enough vitamins for our diet and that people start taking too many vitamin supplements. But still, there are some examples where vitamin supplements are crucial. Pregnant women should take vitamin B9 as it helps to develop the central nervous system of the unborn baby. When vitamin B9 is taken up by the embryo, it is used to make nucleotides. Nucleotides are the building blocks of DNA and we need these basic units a lot in the developing embryo. This then helps the proper development of the brain and peripheral nerves and helps to prevent severe neurological deficits. In elderly adults, moderate levels of vitamin D might reduce the risk of bone fractures. You see, vitamin D supplements support the activity of so-called osteoblasts. Osteoblasts are found in bones and their activity helps to keep bones strong. Vitamin D also helps to build up muscle as it leads to a higher protein synthesis and this can support the mobility of elderly people. Vitamin C might also help to treat critically ill patients. People with multiple organ failure often have very low levels of vitamin C. In many of these conditions, we have an overreactive immune system which destroys surrounding cells. Vitamin C has anti-inflammatory effects, which means that if it's taken up by immune cells, they become less reactive. In critically ill mice, vitamin C was shown to reduce the injury of various organs. And this might then help to counteract inflammation. There have been a couple of older studies which suggest that vitamin C can help to reduce organ damages in trauma patients. More recently, it has also been shown that vitamin C, together with some medication, can reduce damages in sepsis. Mm-hmm. Vitamin supplements are often hailed as natural medicines against a variety of diseases. Unfortunately, this is often not true, and there are many misconceptions. Some say that vitamin supplements can help to prevent heart disease. So a team of scientists analyzed all the data available and found that vitamin supplements do not reduce the risk of heart disease. And to add to that, excessive vitamin E supplements can also increase mortality. So it's not true that vitamin supplements can help to prevent heart disease. The only consistent effect is with fish oil supplementation, which does not help to prevent heart disease, but might decrease the risk of heart infarcts to a small degree at least. Then some say that vitamin supplements help to stop cancer. And well, this is unfortunately wrong. Several studies have failed to find an effect of vitamin D supplements on cancer risks. Some studies suggest that vitamin D supplements might slightly help to increase the survival of cancer patients though. But then there are also vitamin supplements which can actually increase the risks of certain cancers. Provitamin A supplements are associated with a higher risk of lung cancer. Vitamin E supplementation is associated with a 17% increase in prostate cancer risk among men. So yeah, and a bit on the lighter side, some say that vitamin supplements can help to stop aging. Vitamin E is an antioxidant, meaning that it can possibly help to neutralize reactive molecules in the cell. This might then help the overall survival of cells. But also here, unfortunately, no evidence supports the idea that vitamin E supplements alone are sufficient to prevent aging. So yeah, vitamin E supplements are not enough in this case. There are some ways for which we might slow down aging, as we've covered in this video. Vitamin C is often thought to prevent the cold. And this is also not true. However, vitamin C has been shown to reduce the severity of cold symptoms. Similarly to the previous example, vitamin C also has anti-inflammatory effects in flu patients. As a consequence, the immune system doesn't overreact so much and symptoms are not as severe. Vitamin supplements have become a multi-billion industry over the past decades. Vitamins can dramatically improve your life if you have vitamin deficiencies. However, taking vitamin supplements is more complicated than people think. In some cases, they can help to reduce the risk of certain diseases in elderly people. But the excessive use of certain vitamins can also damage the body. Should you take vitamins? Well, this is a question your doctor can answer. He can take a look at your blood and determine whether vitamin supplements can help you or not. I hope that you liked this video. It's the second part of our super healthy lifestyle video series. Let me know what the next part should be about. Otherwise, feel free to like this video and subscribe if you're new here and hit the bell button and do all the other great YouTube stuff. And with that, thank you very much and I'll see ya. If you're interested in how diets and lifestyle might slow down aging, click on this video. If you want to know how a baseball injury made a genius, you might like this video.